Disney has undoubtedly perfected the art of making the audience emotionally invested in their films. They make us laugh, they make us cry, and sometimes they leave a lasting scar in our brains that we can never get rid of. Here are 10 moments in Disney too disturbing to forget. But first, are you not yet a part of the notification squad? No problem. Just click that subscribe button to be the first to find our newest videos. When wolves attack. Things really escalate quickly for Belle in Beauty and the Beast. First, some jerk won't stop hitting on her, then her father gets kidnapped, then she gets kidnapped, and then when she's finally released, she runs into some wolves. And these aren't your friendly Jungle Book wolves. They didn't take her in and raise her as one of their own. No, these were ravenous, bloodthirsty wolves that attacked her and her horse. Although Belle nearly being torn apart by wolves is plenty enough to scar a child, Disney thought it best to throw the Beast into the mix so we could witness him being nearly mauled to death. Between the biting, clawing, and the blood, it's no wonder this scene stands out as disturbing. Bambi's mom dies. Early Disney movies were unquestionably groundbreaking, but positively scarring at the time. Exhibit A, Bambi. This heartwarming film about a doe-eyed little deer had families in stitches when Bambi and Thumper took to the ice. It's quite the iconic scene and has been parodied by many, including The Simpsons. But in a turn of fate that has seemingly become Disney's trademark move, Bambi suffers a devastating loss. The prince's mother finds him a patch of spring grass amidst the winter snow, and together they eat until suddenly a hunter arrives. The deer run as fast as they can, and for a moment Bambi believes they made it home safely. That is, until he ventures back into the snow and calls out to her. The scene is devastating, and coming to the realization as a child that Bambi's mom was hunted down and basically murdered is enough to scar any kid for life. Donkey Boys. During his journey to become a real boy, Pinocchio becomes a real jackass. How, you ask? The same way everyone becomes a jackass. Smoking cigars and drinking beer. When Pinocchio is peer pressured into going to Pleasure Island, he partakes in some pretty questionable activities. He and the rest of the boys go crazy eating junk food, breaking things, fighting and drinking and smoking. Jiminy Cricket finds out that the whole thing was a scam to turn innocent boys into donkeys and ship them off to the highest bidder. We then see the transformation firsthand when Pinocchio's friend morphs into a donkey and spastically thrashes around the room. If that wasn't disturbing enough though, we then see Pinocchio start to suffer the same fate as he too grows long ears and a tail. Thankfully, he gets away before the full transformation. Of course, soon after he escapes, he's swallowed by a scary, ferocious whale, but let's move on. Night on Bald Mountain. The music of Modest Mussorgsky's tone poem Night on Bald Mountain is creepy enough on its own, but that wasn't enough for Disney, so they added some monsters and demons to spice it up for us. This family-friendly scene opens on an ominous mountain, and then from the top unfolds a giant devil-like creature that proceeds to release hell on the town below. He summons ghosts, witches, goblins, skeletons, fiery naked ladies, and many more ungodly beasts of all sorts. Once he's summoned his horde, he tears open a hole in the ground, seemingly prying open the gates of hell and releasing even more devilish creatures into the world. These beings rule the night, dancing around and celebrating their newfound freedom. It isn't until the church bells ring in the early hours of the morning that the creatures are banished back into their holes. Finding Nemo, Chapter 1. If you're unfamiliar with this chapter of Finding Nemo, it's because your parents skipped over this scene before they let you watch it on DVD. If you still don't know that Finding Nemo doesn't start on Chapter 2, now's your opportunity to look away and spare yourself the horror. Marlin and Coral are going to be new parents, and they can barely contain their excitement. But when a barracuda shows up at their doorstep, it changes everything. Marlin tries his best to protect his wife and unborn children, but he gets knocked out of the scuffle. When he finally comes to, he's devastated to find that Coral is gone, along with all of the eggs holding his future sons and daughters, except for one, which is badly damaged. It's easy to see why he's so overprotective. Almost his entire family got eaten. Hellfire. Every Disney villain needs a song to sing. Scar has Be Prepared, Dr. Facilier has Friends on the Other Side, and Judge Claude Frollo has Hellfire. The Hunchback of Notre Dame is certainly not short on creepy moments, but this scene as a kid was just as frightening as it was confusing. To us, it was just some old guy yelling in a fireplace with scary red monks popping up out of nowhere. Then we got older. Now we know it's some demented, horny pervert so obsessed with a gypsy that he needs to either sleep with her or kill her. It's rare to find something that gets more disturbing with age, but Disney found a way to pull it off. The Incinerator. The first Toy Story movie released in 1995 and captured the hearts of millions of viewers. 15 years later, the beloved toys we all loved so much and grew up with almost met their fate in a fiery furnace of death. It's no stretch to say that it was just a tad upsetting. Sure, there are loads of movies where characters have near-death experiences, but the scene in Toy Story 3 was done in such a way that it really felt like there was no way out. Our group of toys scramble to survive, but when the realization of no escape sets in, they can do nothing but hold each other's hands and accept their demise. The scene is truly heartbreaking, and the fact that they accept that they're gonna die is what makes it that much more painfully memorable. Mufasa dies. Scar's a bit upset that Simba took his place in line to the throne. So he does what any character on Game of Thrones would do and murders his brother in front of his nephew. Simba witnesses his father plummet to his death and then finds his lifeless body. He's just a kid and he doesn't know any better, so he repeatedly nudges his father, trying to wake him up. As if that wasn't sad enough, Scar then convinces Simba that he, Simba, was responsible for his father's death. Disney really likes to hammer in the devastation. Wait a minute. Shortly after Simba sings a song about how he just can't wait to become king, his dad dies and he becomes king. I smell foul play. Disney fan theory? Simba was in cahoots with Scar the whole time. It makes perfect sense. Rat attack. Lady is chained up outside when she sees a rat sneak into the house. She barks to alert Aunt Sarah, who's inside, but she's ultimately ignored. Luckily, Tramp comes running to the rescue and confronts the rat in the baby's room. In an effort to protect the baby, Tramp attacks the rat and the two animals fight throughout the whole room, knocking everything over as they go. It all looks incredibly violent, and all of the barking, growling, and intense music makes the fight sound even more horrible. During the commotion, Lady frees herself from the backyard and races into the house. Tramp is injured, but finally puts an end to the rat. When Aunt Sarah finds him, she blames the dog for the incident and calls the dog catcher to take Tramp away. Stomach pains. Ursula's plans finally come to fruition, and she gains control over the entire ocean. She demonstrates her powers by creating massive waves and a giant whirlpool so powerful it brings sunken ships to the surface. Ariel falls into the center of the whirlpool and is trapped at the bottom. Ursula then uses the trident to try and finish off Ariel, but while she's distracted, she doesn't notice Eric sailing a ship right towards her. She turns and sees him just as he drives the sharp bowsprit into her stomach. The viewers actually see it stab her in the front and then come straight out through her back. Then, right after that, for some overkill, she's struck by lightning and dies. Disney probably could have just struck her with lightning to kill her instead of having the gruesome stabbing scene, but such is Disney's way. So, which Disney movie scarred you for life? Share your pain with us in the comments below. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe before moving on to the next CBR video. And keep it tuned here to catch more videos on comic books, movies, TV shows, video games, pop culture, and more.